Hey guys, this is Pavan from Programmer Stack, and today I am going to show you how to find the number of digits in a given integer. So open Def C++, press Ctrl+N for new file, and first I am going to increase the size of the font, so then this should be fine. Okay, so now start with the line hash include stdio.h. Oh sorry, I made a mistake here. Okay, now I'm going to write my main function. In the main function, I'm declaring some variables, so I'm taking the long in data type, so we can find the number of digits of some long numbers, and I'm taking variable as n comma i, and we will be taking a s. Okay, that should be fine. Okay, now what I'm gonna do over here is I'm gonna initialize s with 0. Now we have to take input from the user using this scanf function, the number or the integer whose number of digits we want to find out. So I'm writing scanf LLD ampersand n, that means whatever value user enter will be stored in the variable n. So for that I'm writing scanf n, and I will be using a while loop in order to find the number of digits. So I'm writing while n not equal to 0, that means when n is not equal to 0, okay, n is equal to n divided by 10. Okay, so if n not equal to 0, n equal to n divided by 10, and s plus plus, that means every time this loop will run, the length of the number will be decreased by 1, and our counter variable, that is s, will be incremented by 1. So take for example 123. So 123, the value of n is 123, and since 123 is not equal to 0, then it will enter this while loop, and 123 will be divided by 10, and the new value of n will become 12, and s will be incremented. Again 12 will come over here, again 12 will be divided, s will be incremented, 1 will be left, again 1 will come here over here, and 1 will be divided by 10, and the number will become 0, because n is an integer here, so 1 divided by n will not give us a floating value, it will give us a 0, and again s will be incremented, but the while loop will not run further because the value of n has become 0. So in this we can see the value of s will be incremented 3 times in case of 123. So we can find that the number of digits in 123 is 3. In that way we can do it. Now what we are left with, we have to just print the value of s. So I'm writing number of digits is equal to %LLD slash n, I mean with a new line and s. Okay, so that's fine. Now run the program. So I'm writing digits.c. So here you can see it's compiling, and you can see here 0 errors, 0 warnings. Okay, so now I'm going to run our program. So I'm writing a number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and you can see here number of digits is equal to 6. Okay, you can take some other examples like 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, that means 9 times 9, and you can see here number of digits is equal to 9. Okay, so in this way you can find the number of digits in a given integer in C. So guys, if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel so to get the latest update of new videos, and share the video, like the video, and I'll be back with more good problems. Goodbye.